See important safety information at the end of the video. Only your doctor can determine if this therapy is right for you.
This is way out of tune.
You have to forgive Skip Parks if his music sounds a little off. That'll happen when the guitar sits in the corner for over a year. Severe pain in his back and hips prevented Skip from sitting long enough to even play a song. But something happened recently that changed everything.
Got it.
Doctors implanted a Medtronic spinal cord stimulation device called Intellis in his lower back. It uses electricity to treat the pain that for Skip was regularly unbearable.
I've gone from a 10 plus down to about a 6. So for me, that's huge. 6 I can live with.
An engineer in the Navy, Skip suffered a series of injuries that led to half a dozen back surgeries and left him disabled. For years, doctors treated the intense, immobilizing pain with drugs. But eventually, Skip realized the medication wasn't doing enough to control his pain.
Because I said, okay, that's enough of this, and I'm still in pain. There's got to be something else that I can do.
That's when doctors recommended he try spinal cord stimulation. At Ohio Health in Columbus, Dr. Chris Karras implanted the Medtronic Intellis device low on the left side of Skip's back. Wires or leads run from the rechargeable device and are placed over areas of the spinal cord, delivering tiny electric impulses to treat the pain.
And so we see pain relief immediately in most patients, and we see functional improvement in a very short period of time. Within a week or two, we're seeing functional improvement in patients.
I came out and I was like, I feel great.
Skip is one of as many as 100 million Americans who suffer from chronic pain. Often treated with opioids, it's estimated up to 29% of those pain patients misuse the drugs that are supposed to help them.
It is a huge problem.
Dr. Michael Bourne served on a governor's task force to address Ohio's opioid crisis. He says technology solutions like spinal cord stimulation should be considered more often in treating chronic pain.
It is underutilized to a great degree. While I don't think that spinal cord stimulation is a panacea, what I have found is that it fits great into a multimodal management strategy, especially if opioid sparing is our goal.
There was a time when even lifting a camera was too painful for Skip Parks. But today, his life is more in focus than it's been in years.
The thing that I missed the most was being able to hold my wife at night. And with this machine, I was able to make a couple of adjustments. I can roll over and actually wrap my arms around my wife now. What an amazing thing.
Important safety information. A Medtronic implantable neurostimulation system is indicated as an aid in the management of chronic, intractable pain of the trunk and/or limbs. Implantation and use of neurostimulation system involves risks, including infection, paralysis, lead movement, pain at the implant site, jolting or shocking, and loss of therapy effect. For a list of adverse events that have been associated with the therapy, please refer to important safety information at medtronic.com/safety-neurostimulation. The medical procedure diathermy cannot be used on someone with an implanted neurostimulation device, as this can result in severe injury or death. Most electrical devices and magnets encountered in a normal day are unlikely to affect the operation of a neurostimulator. However, sources of strong electromagnetic interference, such as MRI and RF microwave ablation, can interact with the neurostimulation system, resulting in serious injury or device damage. Not everyone responds to spinal cord stimulation in the same way, and your experience may vary. To understand the benefits and risks, please discuss them in detail with your doctor. A prescription is required. For complete safety information about spinal cord stimulation for chronic pain, call Medtronic at 800-510-6735. Or visit the Medtronic website at medtronic.com/safety-neurostimulation.